So good morning, everyone. So let us introduce. So my name is Zoe Vatto, and this is Pauline Vidot. First of all, we want to thank you for attending this session and thank Barilla for letting us the opportunity to be here today in Milan. We are really happy. Today, the objective of this session is to introduce to you our marketing project to fight against childhood obesity thanks to a responsible and sustainable marketing. So we are studying on this research since 6 months, and we present an exploratory research. So it's not the final stage, it is exploratory. So who are we? We're two students at the ESSEC School of Management in Paris. We are studying marketing. We're in second year of marketing, second year of master. And our collaboration is strong and efficient. Last year, we already collaborated in different marketing projects as the importance of communication tools to promote companies' CSR image. And today, we are really happy and motivated and convinced by the project we are presenting today.
So the problem we want to fight against is named obesity. So according to the World Health Organization, in 2012, more than 1.5 billion people were obese or overweight all around the world. So the consequences are physical, such as many diseases, cardiovascular disease, cancers, diabetes, and with the death as a final purpose. But the consequences are also psychological, like decreased self-esteem, negative body image, which is very harmful when you are considering children when they are developing their own personality at this stage of their lives. But the consequences are also economical, and obesity is very expensive. You may know that in France, for example, the national health expenditures linked to diseases caused by obesity are very important, and also that obese people tend to lose productivity at work, so it's very expensive and it's very time to curb the trend.
But children are the most vulnerable target. So according to the World Health Organization, obesity and overweight represent the fifth leading risk for death globally. And all around the world, 42 million children are obese. So we really have to change this situation. As you can see here on the graph, it is the evolution of the childhood obesity rate from the 60s to 2010. You can see that the evolution is alarming. We really have to curb the trend. Moreover, 70% of the children that are obese today will remain obese in adulthood. So if we don't propose a sustainable solution, the situation won't be improved itself. You have to know that it's right that for some people, marketing can represent a danger for obesity because they influence children's food preferences, and marketing can make people eat unhealthy products. But with Pauline, we want to prove that thanks to sustainable and responsible marketing, so sensorial marketing here, we can change the situation, and this can help to fight against childhood obesity.
So the idea we are introduced to you today is not a concrete project, as you may have seen in previous presentation, but this is a concept. The idea is to deal with central marketing. So central marketing is a set of marketing techniques that target one or more than one of the five senses to promote the purchase of a product or services. So concerning children and the food industry, sensorial marketing has already been adapted, and the change on the products mainly concern the shape, the color, the way to use, the association with a gift, or the smell. But it is really important to know that it concerns only unhealthy and very high content and fat of sugar products. So our idea today is to find a solution with the sensorial marketing to fight against this this multifactor disease that represents childhood obesity. So we want to prove with our ID that with a qualitative research in marketing, we can find a link between sensorial marketing and the fight against childhood obesity. And it's really worth, it's a research that is worth to, it's an investment that is worth to do, and we really believe that it can work.
So now we're going to talk about the feasibility of the project. So how will we do? It's right that nowadays, the academic research concerning the link between sensorial marketing and childhood obesity is not broadly developed. But with Pauline, we went during the month of October in a school, in a primary school located in the Parisian suburbs, and we've met 19 children from 8 to 12 years old coming from different social and cultural backgrounds. And we have discussed with them and tried to understand what was their favorite food and ideal meals. And we tried to understand which sense and the role of each sense had the biggest influence on their behavior according to food. So now you... It's right that we are students, so we can go all around the world, we can go in France, everywhere, in every school. It's like, we need your help. We want to improve the situation, but we are two students, and we want to extend our research and go deeper. So.
And also, we saw through this study with the children that marketing, sensual marketing, has an impact on the way children see the healthy product in their eyes. So it is very important to know today why are we using sensual marketing to promote healthy, unhealthy product, and why not fruit and vegetables. So this is why we are here today to know why. And also, with the way, thanks to this qualitative research, we have seen that there was a ranking in the sense and their importance in children food preferences. And now that we know that, and with the national research, after my marketing design, food designer will be able to create product that matches perfectly the children's expectations, food expectations, and dietary requirements. And you have to know also that to do a marketing qualitative research is a limited investment compared to creating a new project. It is very important to know that it is also possible to improve the situation, to fight against childhood obesity by improving new subjects and not by creating new ones. As for the production of this healthy product, it's also very, we estimate that the investment is also limited as food companies already have the needed infrastructures to produce healthy products. And then our research is only for starts concerning France, but as many food companies are international, we believe that it will be easy to extend this achievement all around the world, and the impact will be all the more positive for CSR company image. So today, we are very convinced that sensual marketing is the solution to fight against childhood obesity. It is a subject that is easy to understand, easy to launch, and now professionals from the food industry have the power to change the situation, to fight against childhood obesity, and it's really time to be the hero you always wanted to be. Thank you.